defined. And is designated by K at its constant rate of depreciation. So dito sa ating rate of sa ating declining balance method, mag-recall muna tayo ng ating discussion before para mas maintindihan ninyo yung ating declining balance method. Let us recall lang yung naging previous discussion natin all about compound interest. Sa compound interest, ano nga ulit yung formula natin ng future value pagdating sa compound interest? O dapat sa ulo natin yan. What is the formula in getting the future worth of a compound interest?
Sir, yung pong present multiply to 1 plus I raised to n.
Yan, tama, no? So, present worth times the quantity of 1 plus I raised to n. So, di ba dati, kung matatanda ninyo, sinolve ko sa ating whiteboard natin yung difference ng simple interest sa compound interest. No, kung tatanda, tanggalin muna natin itong year-end kasi nag-base lang tayo sa year-end kasi depende siya sa number of years. Let us have an example na may present value tayo na 1,000 in sa previous discussion natin. And then, sabihin natin, meron tayong interest na 10%. And may end tayo, sabihin natin, na 2 years na lang. Okay? So at year 0, 'di ba? Yung future value niya is equal pa lang, is equal din sa ating present value which is 1,000. So hindi pa to tumutubo, hindi pa nagkakaroon ng interest. Kasi nasa year 0 pa lang eh. At year 1, using this formula na F is equals to P times the quantity of 1 plus I, lagyan natin nung interest na 10%. 'Di ba? Yung 1,000, lagyan natin ng 10%. Ngayon, tutubo siya ng magkano? Pagkano'ng itutubo niya? Magkano itutubo niya? 'Di ba 100? Kaya naging 1,100. Ito at year 1, ha? At year 2, kung matatanda niyo again yung discussion natin, yung future value o yung may tubo at year 1, ang gagamitin natin siya as a present value at year 2. So yung 1,100, i-times natin sa 1.010, yung future value at year 2 is 1,210. Diba? Using other formula, yung P, 1 plus I raised to 2, diba 1,210 din yan? Tama ba ako? Engineers? Yan.
Yes, po.
So, ito yung application ng compound interest. Ngayon, i-relate natin sa declining balance method. Sa declining balance method, paano natin mai-relate? O, balik tayo sa compound interest. Siyempre, pag nagbigay tayo ng interest, at every year, tumutubo, tumataas yung ating value, tumataas yung present value natin dito, tumataas yung initial payment, initial value natin, initial amount. Dito, sa declining balance method, since declining, nagdi-decline yung ating pera, nababawasan. Bakit nababawasan? Again, based sa previous discussion natin. Pag bumili ako ng isang equipment sa halagang ganito, at ginamit ko siya at ng isang taon, and then ipagbibili ko siya, syempre, yung halaga niya is hindi nakatulad doon sa initial value natin. So, nagde-depreciate, nagde-decline. Kaya, ang gagamitin nating formula dito, since nagde-depreciate, is yung present, yung future worth niya is equal to the present worth times the quantity of 1 minus the interest rate. Okay. At year 1, at year 0, syempre, yung 1,000 pa din. At year 1, P times the quantity of 1 minus I. So, 1,000 times the quantity of 1 minus 0.10, yung future value niya at year 1 is equivalent to what? Engineers, by speaking.
900 po, sir.
900. At year 2, tingnan natin. 1,000 times the quantity of 1, hindi na 1,000, di ba? Kasi, again, application tayo ng compound interest. So, 900 yung gagamitin natin dito. 1 minus 0.10. Anong magiging F2 natin dito?
810.
Meaning to say, sa ating declining balance method, nagde-depreciate. Every year, nagde-depreciate yung value niya. So, gagamitin natin itong formulang ito using our double declining balance at declining balance method. Pero paano muna natin kinocompute yung ating K, yung ating rate of depreciation? Again, recall again tayo, yung I natin is the interest rate. Bakit? Interest rate kasi tumutubo tayo. Ngayon, nagde-depreciate tayo. So, gagamitin naman natin as depreciation as K. Again, I is pag tumutubo and K kapag nagde-depreciate or nagde-decline yung ating initial value. So, paano natin makukompute yung ating K? So, ang K natin is makukompute natin as 1 minus the nth root of the book value all over the first cost, or pwede rin siyang makompute as 1 minus the L root of the salvage value over the first cost. Para hindi kayo malito, book value, di ba, laging katambal niya is N. Salvage value, laging katambal niya is L. Okay? Paliwanag pagdating sa ating rate of depreciation?
Yes po.
Okay. Paano naman? Oops, bakit di ko dinilit? Wait lang. Nadilit ko na to ah. Okay, paano naman kapag annual rate, annual depreciation? Allow me to share the screen again. Paano naman kapag annual depreciation? So, pag annual depreciation, so, yung DN natin is to be computed as DN is equal to KFC times the quantity of 1 minus K raised to N minus 1. Yan yung ating annual depreciation. Take note, again, tayo ay nasa declining balance method. Under siya ng non-uniform. Meaning to say, yung ating D1 is not equal to D2 and not also equal to D3. Nagkakaroon ng pagbabago based doon sa ating depreciation. Siyempre, magde-depreciate from the amount of D1, magde-depreciate siya sa year 2, magde-depreciate siya sa year 3. So paano natin mako-compute yung ating D1? Kasi nga hindi equal yung ating depreciation at every year. So mako-compute natin yung depreciation natin at year 1 as KFC times the quantity of 1 minus K raised to 0. Bakit raised to 0? Kasi ang N natin is 1, minus 1 is 0. Paano pag D2? KFC times the quantity of 1 minus K raised to 1. So, 2 minus 1 is equal to 1. So, D3 as KFC times the quantity of 1 minus K raised to 2. So on and so forth. Naiintindihan po ang formula natin pagdating sa ating annual depreciation?
Yes, po, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Okay, goods. Punta naman tayo sa salvage value. Ang salvage value dito possible, there are times na sa problem is hindi ibibigay. Pero, makocompute natin yung salvage value as the first cost times the quantity of 1 minus K all over L. Okay? Maliwanag po, pagdating sa salvage value kapag hindi binibigay?
Yes, po.
Yes, okay.
Dito lang siya sa double, sa declining balance method, dito lang yung nagkaroon ng formula for the salvage value. For the total depreciation, makukumpute natin yung total depreciation as the summation of the annual depreciation. For example, hinahanap is what is the total depreciation at year 5? At year 3, halimbawa, what is the total depreciation at year 3? Pwede natin ilagay as D1 plus D2 plus D3. Itong summation ng tatlong to, pwede natin maging consider as the summation of the total depreciation. Eh, papaano sir, halimbawa, 55 po ang pinapahanap yung total depreciation. Baka mamaya during the examinations, isang oras pa lang hindi namin makompute yung total depreciation in 55 years. So naggawa tayo ng simplified formula in order to solve the total depreciation. So the total depreciation may be computed as the first cost times the quantity of 1 minus 1 minus k raised to n. Ito po ang pwede nating alternative solution in order to get the total depreciation. And the book value is also similar lang naman sa mga previous book value formula. Okay? May questions ba? Paano naman yung cash flow? Yung cash flow diagram natin, pagdating dito sa ating declining balance method, is same lamang doon sa ating previous cash flow diagram. So first cost is located at year 0, salvage value natin is located at year L, and pa-curve again yung ating diagram, and yung book value natin is located at year N, and yung DN natin, total depreciation, is in between the first cost and the book value, and halimbawa, pinapakompute yung depreciation at year 1, so nandirito siya. D1, D2 is nandirito. Again, take note that D1 is not equal to D2 nor equal to D3. Maliwanag po pagdating sa ating cash flow diagram?
Yes, yes po sir.
Do you have questions with regards to our formula, applications, and the cash flow diagram pagdating sa declining balance method? May question ba kayo? Maliwanag? Yes, ganito.
Sir, dun po sa formula po ng K, yung pong N at saka L, hindi po siya nakalagay po dun. Kumbaga, related lang po yung BV sa N, tapos si salvage value po sa L.
Again, isa-isa. Ulit, mabagal.
Yung pong sa formula po ng sa K, di ba po naglagay po kayo dun sa may taas ng square root ng N at saka L? Hindi po yung nakalagay po dun. No? Kumbaga, related lang po si N sa BV, tapos si L sa salvage value po.
No. Binigyan ko lang kayo ng hint para hindi kayo malito. Ang formula natin dito, ito. Baka malito. Paano ko? Ang K natin, ang formula ng K natin, kapag, halimbawa, ang sa problem, ang mayroong given is book value at saka salvage value. Ito ang gagamitin nating formula. 1 minus the nth root of the book value all over the first cost. Kapag namang salvage value, K is equals to 1 minus the L root of the salvage value divided by the first cost. Kasi baka mamaya gamitin mo tong formulang ito, ang given is salvage value. Di ba hindi mo makocompute to kapag ang given is salvage value. So ito ang gagamitin nating formula. Okay? Naka-N root siya and the N, naka-L root siya. So dalawang formula natin pagdating sa K.
Okay po sir, salamat po.
Okay, may questions pa? Question pa? Before we proceed sa problem number 1. Goods na?
Yes, goods.
Okay, sige. Let us try to solve problem number 1. So, for problem number 1, determine the rate of interest, the total depreciation up to the end of 8th year, and the book value at the end of 8 years for an asset that cost 15,000 new and has an estimated scrap value of 2,000 at the end of 10 years using the declined balance method. Halimbawa, for example, So problem natin, hindi in-state yung problem as the declining balance method. Paano natin may evaluate na declining balance siya? Yan o, may nakalagay na rate of depreciation or K. Eh sir, possible po kasi sa problem hindi ibigay yung rate of depreciation. Halimbawa po, wala pong sinabi dyan. I-state naman na ang gagamitin is declining balance method. Okay? Sige. The second one, alamin natin kung ano yung hinahanap. Rate of depreciation, K, yung total depreciation of the end of the 8 years. Ito ba ay malaking K or ito ba ay malaking D or maliit na D?
Malaking D po.
Malaking D. And yung ating book value at year 8. Now, proceed tayo with the given. So, ano yung ating first cost here?
15,000 po.
15,000. And ano ang ating salvage value?
2,000 po.
2,000. Ano ang ating N? May N ba tayo dito?
Meron po.
What is our what is the value of N?
8 years po.
8 years. And L is 10. Okay. Proceed tayo with the cash flow diagram. Ito naman kahit sa uluhin natin. Ang mahalaga, tama lang yung pagde-designate ng ating book value. So dito medyo maghihigpit ako. Kasi halimbawa walang book value, imamali ko talaga. Okay. Salvage value natin na 2,000. Wait lang ha. Nasaan si Serrano? Nasaan si Serrano? Mark? Serrano?
Ako po ba, sir?
Sir?
Nga ngayon ka lang umaten?
Hindi po, sir. Kanina pa po ako nag-a-student po eh. Hindi po na-access.
Late na kasi nag-start kami. Late na eh, mga 15 minutes.
Hindi, ano po, sir? Mga nasa... Parang mga 10 minutes pa po ata akong nag-access nung simula po ng 10. Mga 10-12 po. Or 10-10, mga ganun po.
15 minutes late kami nag-start kasi nga inihintayin namin. Habol ka na lang ha.
Okay po sir.
Okay. Sige. 15,000. Again, pa-curve to. Book value natin is at year 8. Ano ba? Nasa year 8 tayo. 10 to. BV8. Okay? And yung total depreciation natin at year 8 is nandito. Okay tayo with the cash flow. Tama ba?
Yes po, sir. Tama po.
Okay. Good. Ngayon, let us try, sir. Let us try first to solve yung ating K. Yung ating K, anong gagamitin nating formula? Diba may salvage value? So, 1 minus yung L root ng salvage value all over the first cost. Sige nga. Meron tayong L, salvage value, FC. What is the value of K?
18.25% po.
Okay. 0.1824. Wag magra-round up ha. 884943. So therefore, ang K natin is 18.24884943%. Maghihigpit ako sa finals kapag ang sinasabi is rate, any kind of rate, and then naka-decimal places kayo, imamalito na yun ha, hindi ko na i-consider. Good tayo doon. Pag rate, laging dapat naka-percentage. Maliwanag, engineers?
Yes po, sir.
Okay po, sir.
Okay, good. Maliwanag tayo doon ha. So, okay na tayo for the value of K. Ngayon, compute-in natin yung D8. Paano natin makukumpit yung D8? Diba may formula tayo ng D8? Example, ang i-consider nating D8 is yung FC times the quantity of 1 minus 1 minus K raised to N. Tama ba ang formula natin?
Yes po, sir.
Okay. Sige nga, substitute lang. 15,000 times the quantity of 1 minus 1 minus 0.18, wag ira-round off, raised to 8. So, what is the value of D8?
12,744426.
Wait lang, nagko-compute dito. Multitasking. Raise to 8. 12! Ay, bakit mali ako? 15,000. 15,000, 1 minus. Tama naman. Wait lang ha. 15,000, 1 minus 1 plus point. A raise to 8. Ah, 1 minus. 1 minus. So, 12,007.44426. Nakuha ba ng lahat itong D8, guys?
Yes, yes po, sir.
Yes, po, sir. Yes.
Okay. Itrain naman natin, halimbawa, isolve siya as the summation. No? Kumbaga, D8, halimbawa, nakalimutan natin yung formula. Summation ng D1 plus hanggang ng D8. Sige nga, ganto na lang. Ako magsusolve. I-confirm ninyo kung tama yung ating sagot. So, ang D1 natin is KFC times the quantity of 1 minus K raised to 0. Bakit raised to 0? N minus 1 is equals to 0. Okay? Ang D1 natin is, pa-confirm ako if tama, 2327.3274. Tama ba ang D1 natin?
Yes, please.
Pa-confirm ako by speaking.
Tama po, sir.
Yes, please.
Ilagay ko to lang, i-ship store ko lang siya as B. On my own lang to. Bahala kayo kung anong gusto nyo. O pag D2, ang D2 natin is 2237.7966. Tama ba ang ating D2?
Tama po.
Yes po, sir.
Shift star ko lang siya as C. Ito yung sinasabi ko sa inyo na gusto kong makita sa solution nyo, no? The formula. So, ito, lalagyan nyo lang din ng formula, ha? Yung shift store nyo to, kahit okay na to, intindi ko yan na shift store nyo yan. Ilalagay nyo lang yung value. Okay. For D3, pa-check out ko kung 1829.424514. Tama ba ang D3 natin?
Yes po, sir.
Shift store ko lang as letter D. So, D4. Ang D4 natin is 1495. I-store niyo yung K, ha, para bilis. 575589. Tama ba ang ating D4?
Tama po.
Store ko lang siya as E. Ang D5 naman, Ang D5 natin is 1,222.650252. Tama ba ang D5 natin?
Yes.
Okay. Nakakasabay ba? Nakakasabay? Kinocompute lang natin yung annual depreciation at every year. Nakakasabay pa?
Yes. Yes, po, sir. Yes, po.
Sige. D6. Ang D6 natin is 999.5306481. Tama bang D6 natin?
Yes,
tama. Yes po, sir.
Yes, po, sir.
Okay, lagay ko lang siya as M. D7 is 817.1278051. Tama ba ang ating D7?
Tama po, sir.
Okay, lagay ko lang siya as Y. And yung ating D8, which is 668.011.3823. Tama ba ang D8 natin?
Yes, tama po.
Yes po, sir. Okay,
lagay ko lang sa ating X. Ngayon, itotal nyo to from D1 to D8. Pa-check nga ako kung tama dito sa ating D8.
Same naman po.
Same po.
Okay, nakuha ng lahat. Tama ba?
Yes po.
I mean to say, halimbawa, nakalimutan tong formula to. Pwede nating maging alternative solution yung summations at every year. Yun nga lang, pag 55, 105, ay doon tayo mahihirapan. Okay, so mas maganda talagang sauluin na natin yung formula natin, pinaka-simplified formula pagdating sa total depreciation. And then, kung mapapansin nyo, kung papansin ninyo, yung depreciation at every year, talagang nagde-depreciate, nagde-decline, nag-bumababa. So 2.7, naging 2.2, naging 1.8, naging 1.4, naging 1.2, naging 900, naging 800, naging 660. Hindi po pwede na mas mataas ang D3 sa D1. Ano? Kasi hindi na siya under ng depreciation. Maliwanag po pagdating sa computation ating total depreciation using these two kind or two options of solution. Okay na? Yes, Justin.
Sir, excuse me. Pero yung summation po, kasi sa kanji po ay parang may summation po, ilalagay na lang po yung range nung sa N. Pwede po kaya yun kung sakali?
Okay, sure. Sige. Pero gusto kong makita yung mga value at every year.
Okay po, thank you.
Yung okay, ano, ilalagay mo na lang. Basta, for checking lang siya, pero kailangan nyo parang ilagay yung mga value at every year. Kasi baka mamaya, nangopya ka lang kay Micaela ng total depreciation. So, kailangan na i-proof ka na compute mo yung total depreciation. Goods. Gawin mo na lang siya as your solution. Sir, check. Okay. Di kasi ako nag-aalaw ng mga calculator techniques. Okay, goods, Justin.
Goods. Thank you po.
Okay. Ngayon, book value. So, yung book value naman is madali lang naman yung makompute. So, yung wala namang pinagbago. Yung value at year 8 is yung first cost minus doon sa ating book value. So, what is the value of our book value at year 8? 2,992.57. Maliwanag po pagdating sa ito sa ating declining balance method.
Yes,
may question ba kayo?
Wala po, sir.
Naiintindihan? Gets na?
Gets po.
Sige. Let us proceed with the next topic, which is the double declining balance method. The double declining balance method, this method is similar sa declining balance method, except that the rate of depreciation is K, which is replaced by 2 over L. So same na same lang din naman ang cash flow, same ng formula. Ang pinagkaiba nga lang, yung K is i-replace natin as 2 over L. Okay po. Yun lang. Annual depreciation, salvage value, total depreciation, book value, same lang din. Palitan lang natin yung K as K over 2 over L. Okay tayo sa double declining. Okay, ganito.
Sir, ano po yun? Type lang po yung small letter L dun po.
Ay, sige. Yes, it is a big letter L. Any confirmation pa? Okay, may question pa? Goods na? Can we proceed sa problem number 1? Dito sa double declining?
Yes po, sir.
Okay, so sige. Okay naman yung mag-solve. Since ako nag-solve nung sa declining balance method, so bigyan ko kayo ng chance to solve for the double decline. And a-chat ako ng sagot natin sa ating chat box. Okay, other answer. Okay, so sige nga, tingnan natin kung tama yung mga sagot ninyo. Determine the rate of depreciation, the total depreciation up to the end of the 8th year, and the book value at the end of 8th year for an asset that cost 15,000 new and has an estimated scrap value of 2,000 at the end of 10 years using the double declining balance method. Okay. First, ano yung method na gagamitin natin? So, double declining method. The second one, ano yung mga requirement? Rate of depreciation, K, the total depreciation at year 8, and the book of value at year 8. So, tatlo. So, given, kanina naman na evaluate na natin yung given, so hindi ko natanungin sa inyo, i-copy ko na lang dito. Salvage value na may 2,000 and may N tayo na 8 years, may L na 10 years. So paano natin makakompute yung A? Very simple. Ang K natin is to be computed as 2 over L. So 2 divide 10 is equal to 0.2 or 20%. So dito, sa double declining balance method, hindi na tayo gagamit nung K is equal to 1 minus the L root of the book of the salvage value divide the first cost. Hindi na tayo gagamit ng mga ganun. Simply, 2 over L lang. Okay, maliwanag po doon pagdating sa rate of depreciation under the double declining balance method.
Yes, po, sir.
Good. Sige, proceed tayo with the D8. So D8 natin, punta na lang tayo sa pinaka-simplified, ha? First cost times the quantity of 1 minus 1 minus k raised to n. So ito, palitan lang naman natin. So 15,000 times the quantity of 1 minus 1 minus 0.2 raised to 8. Therefore, ang D8 natin is equivalent to what? 12,483.8. 4176. Nakuha ba ng lahat itong D8? Engineers?
Yes po, sir.
Okay.
Good. Yes po, sir.
Proceed tayo with the book value. Yun nga lang. Ima-minus lang naman natin. Therefore, ang book value naman natin at year 8 is 2,516.5824. Okay? Maliwanag po pagdating sa ating double declining balance method. Ganun lang. Cash flow diagram, di ko na nilagay, ha? Kasi same lang din naman ng cash flow diagram sa declining balance method. Sir, paano po kapag sa problem, hindi nyo po sinabi, ang in-state nyo lang po is balance method. Hindi po namin alam kung ang gagamitin is declining balance method or yung double declining balance method. Kasi po, magkaiba po yung naging sagot ng K, D8, at saka BV8. Tatandaan ninyo, kapag ang problem is nakalagay is balance method, ang gagamitin nating formula or susundin natin is yung ating standard, yung ating declining balance method. Okay? Hindi tayo gagamit ng double declining balance method. Gagamit lang tayo kapag in-state mismo sa problem na double declining balance method. If hindi, ang gagawin nating formula or susundin natin is yung standard po. Yung ating declining balance method. Maliwanag po doon?
Yes po.
Yes po, sir.
Kasi baka mamaya ang gamitin yung formula ay, sir, dala po kasi yung type ng declining balance method eh. In-state ko na sa inyo, in-emphasize ko na ang gagamitin natin is yung standard declining balance method. Okay, may questions kayo regarding dito sa ating double declining? Clear ba? Maliwanag?
Yes po, sir.
Okay, proceed tayo with the last, with the next topic for the method of the depreciation, which is the sum of the year's digit or SOYD kung tawagin namin. Wala na tong M. SOYD. It is a method of evaluating depreciation where the depreciation changes from year to year. Nagbabago yung depreciation niya from year to year din. Again, under siya ng non-uniform, meaning to say, yung D1 na is not equal sa D2, not equal sa D3. Kumbaga, may pagbabago doon sa kanyang annual depreciation. Okay? For the annual depreciation, ito yung sasauluhin nating formula. So, Dn is equal to 2 times the quantity of L minus N plus 1 all over L times the quantity of 1 L plus 1 times the quantity of the first cost minus the salvage value. Okay tayo for the annual depreciation. For the total depreciation is N times the quantity of 2L minus N plus 1 all over L times the quantity of L plus 1 times the quantity of the first cost minus the salvage value. And the book value, very constant, yung formula, which is the first cost minus the total depreciation. For example, for the D1, so 1 to, pag D2, N is equals to 2. Okay? Ito is yung first option. Meron akong second option na ibibigay sa inyong solution, which is ito yung ginagamit kong solution during the board exam. And also, during nung student ako, nung ako ay nag-e-echo. Ito yung second option na pwede nyong gawin for your computations. Okay, start muna tayo for the annual depreciation. Umaalin sa dalawa. So, hindi ko naman ni-encourage na ito yung gamitin nyo, pero ito yung isang way in order to solve the sum of the year's digit other solution. So, ang depreciation niya is first cost minus salvage value times yung reverse period divided by the SOYD. Or yung reverse period, pwede nyo rin siyang first cost minus salvage value times the quantity of L minus N minus 1 all over SOYD. Ako, kilo na. Where yung SOYD natin is to be computed as L all over 2 times the quantity of 1 plus L. O paano yun? For example, halimbawa sa problem, may life of service na 10 years and then pinapahanap dito is what is the total what is the depreciation at year 5? No, at year 5. So ganito ang magiging solution niyan. Para mas maintindihan, maglagay ako dito ng cash flow. Pero kahit hindi na, maglagay lang ako. Para mas maintindihan lang. 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Kasi ang L natin is equivalent to 2. Ang hinahanap is the D5. So ang D5 is makocompute natin as yung first cost, minus salvage value, i-divide natin sa Anong SOYD natin dito? SOYD is, di ba, 10 divide 2 times the quantity of 1 plus 10. Ano magiging SOYD natin? 55. So sa denominator, ilalagay natin yung 55 years. Ano yung magiging reverse period? Sa reverse period, kung ang total length natin is 10, ilagay natin to as D1, D2, D3, D4, D5, D6, D7, D8, D9, and D10. Ngayon, nag-reverse tayo. Ang hinahanap is D5. Sa D5, siya ay at year 6. So, itatimes natin sa 6. Okay? Naiintindihan doon sa reverse period na yon?
Okay po, sir.
Halimbawa, D7 naman. So, sa D7 o the year 4, pag sa D3, 8 ang ilalagay natin. O, kung nalilito sa reverse period, ito ang gamitin ninyo. So, 10 minus, anong ating hinahanap D5, di ba? 5 minus 1 is 4. So, 4, 10 minus 4 is equals to 6. So, ganun din. Maliwanag po for the reverse period or yung L minus N minus 1?
Yes, po.
Engineers?
Yes, po.
No, no, one po, sir.
Okay.
Yes, po, sir.
Okay, goods. Alam mo, for example, for D2, para mano lang, first cost minus salvage value, anong magiging N dito? Reverse period. Again?
9 po.
9. Yan. 9 divide 55. O pag D3, anong ilalagay nating reverse period?
8
divide 55. O, maliwanag pa, maliwanag tayo pagdating sa annual depreciation. Hey guys.
Yes, yes po, sir.
Yes,
okay.
Po.
Yes, yes.
Paano naman yung ating total depreciation? So, yung total depreciation is pwede natin namang ma-compute as first cost minus salvage value, i-divide lang natin sa summation noong reversed period, i-divide sa SOYD. Halimbawa, at year 5, ilan yung reverse period at year 5? So, ito ay kukonsider natin. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Meaning to say, at year 5 to ha, first cost minus salvage value, halimbawa, D5 is equal to reverse over 10 plus 9 plus 8 plus 7 plus 6. Bakit? Again, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Yung D1, D2, D3, D4, and D5. I-divide natin sa 55. So, yun na yung magiging D5 natin. Or kung gusto ninyo, yung D5 can be computed as summation ng D1 plus D2 plus D3 plus D4 plus D5. Yun nga lang, pag madami, pwede natin itong gawin. Okay? Goods tayo doon? Sa the summation of the reversed period. Goods po? Naiintindihan yung second option formula?
Yes po, sir.
Okay. Book value, same lang din naman. Book value is BVN first cost minus the depreciation, total depreciation at N years. Do you have questions or clarifications? Pagdating naman dito sa second option natin, for our formula sa sum of the year's digit. May question ba? Maliwanag?
Maliwanag po, sir.
Okay, sige. Proceed tayo with the problem number 1. Sige nga. Kayo nga, guys. A machine cost 70,000 and an estimated life of 10 years with a salvage value of 5,000. So, what is the depreciation at 7th year and the book value after 5 years using the sum of the year's digit method. Okay. Kung mapapansin nyo dyan, dalawa yung years. Pero try to evaluate the given, the problem. Other answer? Okay, sige nga. Tingnan natin kung tama yung ating kung tama yung mga naging sagot natin based sa naging sagot nyo sa chat box. So a machine costs 70,000 and an estimated life of 10 years with a salvage value of 5,000. So what is the depreciation at 7th year and the book value after 5 years using the sum of the year's digit? So sabi dito sa mga chat box ninyo, mga chat nyo sa ating chat box, ding maliit yung hinahanap. And yung book value at year 5. So, tingnan nyo yung difference ha. Year 7 and year 5. So let us try first evaluate all the given. O SOYD method, ngayon ang hinahanap is book value and the depreciation at the 7th year. So given yung ating first cost na 70,000 and yung ating salvage value na 5,000. Ang N natin is pwedeng 5 years and 7 years kasi dalawa yung gagamitin natin. And yung L natin is 10 years. So cash flow diagram again. So first cost natin is 70K. Salvage value is 5,000. Pa-curve yung diagram natin and ang hinahanap during the 5 year is the book value. And sa year 7, ang hinahanap naman dito is yung depreciation at year 7. So tama ba yung ating cash flow diagram? Engineers? Yes. Tama, yung ating cash flow diagram. So, paano natin makocompute yung D7? So, yung D7 is to be computed as, ayun nga pala, nasa declining ako. D7 can be computed as first cost minus salvage value times the quantity of L minus N minus 1 all over SOYD. So, kumpitin muna natin yung SOYD. So, SOYD is equal to L over 2 times the quantity of L plus 1. So, ano ang ating SOYD?
55.
Engineers, 55 years. 55 years yung ating SOYD. Anong magiging? Ah, sige. First cost is 70,000. Minus salvage value na 5,000. Anong magiging ano natin dito? Sagot natin dito sa reverse period. Guys.
4
divide sa 55. Check nga natin. Sige, what is our D7 muna? So tama naman kayo. D7 is equal to 4,727.272727. Sige nga, i-check natin kung tama nga yung ating year 4. Sorry, verse 10, 9, 8. Ginagawa ko ito, so, ginagawa ko to for checking lang. 5 and 4. So D1, D2, D3, D4, D5, D6, D7. So tama naman na 4 yung ating gagamitin na reverse period. Maliwanag po, nakuha po ba natin yung ating D7?
Yes po, sir.
Yes po, sir.
Good. Proceed tayo with the BV5. So yung ating book value of year 5 is to be computed as the first cost minus the D5. Alam natin that the formula in getting the D5, CC, kindly close the door. I'm teaching. D5 is equivalent, close the door. D5 is equivalent to FC times the quantity of 1. Ay, malala. Declining ako. Ang D5 natin is to be computed as the first cost minus the salvage value times the quantity of the summation of the reverse period divided by the SOYD. So, 70,000 times the minus yung 5,000. Ito times natin sa reverse digit. Summation ng reverse. Since 5 years, hanggang saan tayo? Mabis dito. Hanggang saan tayo?
6 po.
Sa 6, no? Kasi 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Yun yung i-consider natin. So, 10 plus 9 plus 8 plus 7 plus 6. I-divide lang natin sa 55. So, therefore, ang D5 natin is equivalent to 47,000. Tama ba? 47,272.72. Okay? Tama yung D5 natin?
Tama po, sir.
Yes, po, sir.
Tama po, sir.
Okay. Pero hindi naman ito yung hinahanap. Ang hinahanap natin is yung ating book value at year 5. So, ang book value natin at year 5 is equivalent to 22,727.27273. Okay? Tama ba ang ating book value at year 5?
Yes po, sir.
Yes po, sir.
Yes po, sir.
Okay. Nakakasabay? Nakakasabay pa?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Any questions with regards sa ating sum of the year's digit? I-try nyo din yan dun sa formula natin. Ito, i-try nyo din dito, no? So, similar lang din yung magiging sagot dyan sa ating option 2. It's just that gusto ko lang yung option 2 kasi mas mabilis lang siyang i-compute. And then, hindi mahirap sa uluhin. Okay? Do you have questions so far? May question ba kayo?
Wala po, sir.
Wala naman po, sir.
Nakakasabay?
Yes po, sir.
Okay. Ganun lang talaga yung magiging senaryo ng ating exam. Ang magiging kalaban nyo lang dyan is yung limang type of depreciation. Siyempre, pag nagalahalo yung limang yan, so, kailangan ma-designate talaga natin sa utak natin kung ano talagang type of depreciation yung gagamitin. Okay tayo doon? Formula lang. Sauluin lang yung formula, sauluin yung application. Hindi mababago yung solution natin. Ang madadagdag lang yan siguro. Konting given, pero consider dyan as first cost. Or may mga given dyan na ilalagay, pero hindi naman siya gagamitin. Kumbaga pampagulo lang. No, doon ko lang kayo lilituin, pampagulo lang. Pero yung magiging solution natin is based doon sa mga formula na binigay ko sa inyo. Okay tayo doon? Engineers?
Yes, sir.
Asya, sige, ang payo ko lang sa inyo, kayo ay mag-solve ng maraming problem. As if possible, yun nga, paiikutin ko lang ang ating magiging questions dito na hindi lang puro book value, again, pwedeng salvage value, pwedeng lahat, pwedeng makuha dito. Okay? So, sige, I think that would be all muna for today. Ayun, sa next meeting natin, itutuloy natin yung discussion natin for the depreciation pa din. Ano? So, meron lang tayong mga idadagdag na other topics to be discussed in the methods of depreciation. So, yun lang. So, thank you so much for your time. So, hopefully, may natutunan kayo. Please, request ko lang, mag-solve ng mga problems, mag-practice ng mga problem, sauluin yung mga formulas, and also, parecall ako ng mga discussion natin before kasi sa susunod na topic natin, pagkatapos ng depreciation, babalik rin tayo from the very beginning. So, yung magiging discussion natin sa susunod na topic after the depreciation is related from the simple interest up to depreciation. Kumbaga, yung pinaka-foundation ng ating discussion is from the simple interest to depreciation. Ngayon, pagsasama-samahin na natin lahat yon in one problem. And one problem pero two or more conditions. Okay tayo doon? So, imagine nyo yun ha, from the simple interest hanggang depreciation, yun, doon na tayo mag-start. Okay tayo doon, engineers?
Yes po, sir.
Yes po, sir.
Okay. Sige, if wala na kayong questions, that would be all for today. So, ingat kayo and have a blessed Sunday. Ingat kayo, bye-bye. Thank you.
Thank you po, sir. Thank you, sir.